I'm Chef Jonathan. Today I'm going to show y'all how to make homemade mushroom ravioli. Okay, the first thing we are going to get is 3 tablespoons of butter, and we're going to put it right here in our skillet. Then we're going to get 2 cups of, I'm using chopped portobello mushrooms. You can use whatever mushroom that you like, whether it's button, shiitakes, or a mixture of different wild mushrooms, which should be really good. And we're going to put it right in here. And we're going to get 1/2 cup of diced onion and 1 clove of garlic that I already chopped up and put in here. And we're just basically going to saute all this together. Okay, our mushrooms and our onions are sauteed down really well. Now your mushrooms are going to release some water, so you just want to keep cooking it down until all the water is cooked out. And then all we're going to do is we're going to bring our mushrooms right over here. This is going to be our filling. We're just going to put them in the bowl. Get all this in here, this onion and garlic. Okay, then to this we are going to add an egg. Okay, we're also going to add 4 tablespoons of Parmesan cheese. I'm going to add 2 ounces of mixed cheese. This is a Romano, a Provolone, and Asiago cheese that we're putting in here. And then we're just basically going to mix this up. And I'm just going to mix it up by hand because it's easy to do. You can use a fork if you want or whatever, but I'm just gonna mix it by hand because it's simple. All right, now that it's nice, all good mixed up, we're just gonna set this aside. Okay, now we're gonna make our ravioli dough. What I have in a blender, our mixer over here already, is 2 1/4 cups of flour. I went ahead and put that in there ahead of time. And then to that, we're gonna add 3 eggs, because this is an egg pasta. And we're gonna add 3/4 tablespoon of salt. And we're gonna add 1 tablespoon of olive oil. That right down in there. And I'm gonna let the blender mix it. I'm using the dough hook on this. And what you're gonna wanna do is stop it periodically, get the flour in there closer to the center. Swapped out the dough hook for the paddle. Our dough is getting all mixed up with the egg, and what I want to do is slowly add some water, because I just want this all to blend in nicely. I don't want it too wet, but I also don't want it too dry. So I'm just going to add it like about 1 tablespoon at a time. Okay, and we really didn't need but like 1 1/2 tablespoons of water. Okay, I'm just gonna put our dough out here on the counter. I floured it up, and I'm just gonna knead it up a little bit. Not a lot, just enough. Doesn't need to be overdone. Get a knife, and we're just gonna cut it right in half. I'm going to set 1/2 aside, and then I'm going to take this half and we're going to roll it out. And we're going to roll this out really thin, because we don't need it thick, because this is going to be our ravioli noodles. Make sure you flour up your rolling pin really well. You're gonna have to turn this over a lot, make sure the dough doesn't, make sure it's good and floured so the dough doesn't stick to the rolling pin. Okay, I went and rolled out both halves of our dough, and I'm just gonna take this and I'm gonna roll it just like that. I got one of these nifty little devices here. This is for making ravioli. Now you can do it by the hand the hard way, which I'm not gonna do, or you can use this nifty little device that I have. Basically, all I'm kind of doing is working the dough toward the little pockets to make little pockets into the dough. You gotta be careful because the edges on that thing are sharp. And then all we're gonna do is we're gonna take our filling and we're gonna put it in each one of these little pockets. Okay, now I got our filling into each one of these little pockets on this little round dough thing, ravioli cutter. And I'm gonna take our other dough that I had rolled up. Basically, all we wanna do is put it right over top. Now, I don't know if this thing is still available in stores, whatnot. I hadn't seen it, but somebody got it for me and wanted me to try it out. So, this is the first time I've tried this thing out. So, I'm doing it here with you all on this video. So basically all it's we're supposed to do is take your rolling pin and go right over top of it, and it's gonna cut our dough for us. And they're just gonna fall down into the little pockets. Now it's supposed to come with its own little rolling pin, but it wasn't with it. All right, now all I'm gonna do is take this top dough off. Be careful to try not to pull out any of the little raviolis that didn't cut well. And I'm gonna set this aside, lift this up, give it a little shake. And there we go, perfectly formed, perfectly sealed little raviolis. Okay, we're gonna make a garlic and herb sauce to go along with our raviolis. What I've got in my pot here is 2 tablespoons of butter. And I've got onion and garlic, which I chopped up. About half a cup of onion, a clove of garlic. And we're just gonna saute this up in our pot here. And I also got our water on for our ravioli. This isn't gonna take long. Okay, our onions and our garlic are sauteing up nice and good. They're kind of getting that little bit of clear look to them, as you can see. And then what we're going to add to it is some chicken stock. And this is about a half a cup of chicken stock. Now you can make your own homemade chicken stock if you want. Or you can do like I do and go to the store and they sell a nice chicken stock. And Swanson's makes one. It's just whoever at your local market. Adjust our heat here, and we're just gonna let this start getting hot. And we're gonna let it simmer a little bit. And then I'm gonna show you what we're gonna do from there. Okay, now our onions, garlic, the butter, and the chicken stock are all simmering up nice and good. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna make a little roux. So I'm gonna grab some flour. I'm gonna grab 2 tablespoons of flour, and the roux is gonna be our thickener. And I'm gonna show you guys how to make a roux up ahead of time. So all you have to do is add the roux when you need it. And we're just gonna let this cook up. We're not gonna let it cook too long because we don't want the roux to brown. We want it to be a blonde roux. There's two different stages of roux. I think I went over this with you guys before. There's blonde roux, which is white, and then the more you cook it, it becomes brown, and if it gets a real nutty, it'll be a real nutty smell, and we don't really want brown. So we're just gonna keep stirring this up. Okay, our roux is cooking up. It's getting all nice and thick in here. It's all mixed in with the onion. I didn't let it get brown because I don't want brown roux because I don't want brown sauce. And I'm gonna add 2 cups of milk to this. And we're just gonna mix it right in. Now make sure you cook the roux pretty good because you don't want that flour flavor. And we're just gonna mix this all right in. Okay, now we got our milk in here, and everything's heating up and cooking. We're gonna add the good stuff. All right, basically this is salt, pepper, white pepper, oregano, basil, garlic, and some rosemary. And we're gonna put that right in there. And we're just gonna mix it all right in. And then, come over here. Gonna grab some white wine, and this is a Chardonnay, and this one's dry, and we're gonna add about a half a cup of white wine. And then basically we're just gonna let this cook, and then I'm gonna add my raviolis to our pot of water that we got on over here and show you what this looks like when it's done. Okay, I got our ravioli out. They cooked up. And then I'm just gonna add our sauce here right on top. And so there you have mushroom ravioli with a herb cream sauce.